is, guys. It's your boy Blastphamoushd. Now, I'm pretty sure at this point a lot of you guys are probably wondering, but Blastphamoushd, how are you still alive if all this crazy crap keeps happening to you? At this point, I don't know. Now, I have seen crazy, crazy things, okay? And by far, this is one of the craziest situations I've ever seen unfold in front of me. There's certain places where you don't expect to see violence at. Grocery store, daycare center, skating rink full of women and children. And it is just certain places where you don't expect people to be violent at. Boy, were we wrong. Now, a lot of you guys don't know this about me, but I enjoy to skate. I have a great time. It's good cardiovascular. I tend to look good doing it sometimes. I'm gonna edit that out. So I'm there, man. I'm doing my thing, man. I'm getting my skate on and whatnot. And the night was good. You know what I mean? The DJ was playing the crunk music. You know what I'm saying? Big bank take little bank. Big bank take little bank. You know what I mean? Like, stuff was going great. Bro, they had actual of age females in there and everything, yo. Like, the night was going delicious. Now, while I'm skating, I have like a couple of people that I'm real cool with that I see every time. You know what I mean? Like, we always hang out. So I'm up there skating, man. I'm doing my thing. And in order to be good at skating, you gotta be hella perceptual. You know what I'm saying? And what I mean by that is you gotta be able to take in all your surroundings so you can gauge how fast you skate in and not to skate into people and how not to fall or trip. Cause kids always go the opposite direction. Swear to God, one of these days, I'ma clothesline the hell out of one of them little and probably go to prison very closely after. So with my newfound senses of perception, people. So with my newfound sense of perception, I see an argument popping off in the part where people usually put their skates on. I don't think nothing of it. I'm thinking, okay, well, you know, the dude got his feelings hurt. He mad. You know what I mean? He's the other chick. Ain't nothing gonna pop off because there's too many people here. You feel me? Boy, was I misguidedly wrong. Bruh. So, I'm skating with the homie, and you know, we all doing our things, man. We all like to, you know, skate and joke and, you know what I mean? Like, you know how dudes do, you know what I mean? We skate dancing and whatnot, man. We doing our thing and whatnot, yeah. Until one of the dudes that we were skating with, out of nowhere, like, he's just not around us anymore. I didn't think too much of it, you know what I mean? Because, you know, we ain't checking for dudes and whatnot. Maybe he got himself into something, you know what I mean? He's cool. Again, I'm thinking everything's cool because this place is filled with women and children. Violence don't pop off in front of women and kids, you know what I'm saying? Because of YouTube's extremely strict policies, you know what I mean? Like, the hit, like, it happening. So we just gonna fast forward past the whole altercation. And I'm gonna tell y'all, like, everything up from the part of the most violence. The homie gets hit in the face by the dude that we ain't never seen there before. It really didn't make a whole lot of sense to me. Cause all I saw was the dude's, you know, fist bottled up real quick, bah, and then, you know what I mean? And the homie, he tried to fight the dude back or whatever, but I thought the dude hit him so hard, so fast, that it was just all the way bad, you know? I ain't seen that much blood in a long, long time. I'm thinking it's a fight, like, you know what I mean? My me senses start popping off. I'm like, oh snap, it's a fight. So I go get closer to see the fight, and that's when I start noticing the huge amounts of blood, and it is everywhere. Like, it's littered up and down the freaking floor. It's on the things where people, you know what I mean, the little guardrails. It's on the little guardrails, bruh. It was so much freaking blood, and I'm like, is this man a boxer? Did the homie get into a fight with Mike Tyson or something? We gonna call the homie Jamal. Jamal is going absolutely ballistic. He literally had 12 dudes on him and he was literally like picking them up and dragging them all. And this just weren't kids and women. These were dudes, grown dudes, was trying to hold dude back from fighting the dude that had, you know, sucker punched him or whatever. In my mind, I'm like, bruh, it's a fight. Let it happen. You know what I mean? Like, just let the homie at him. Let the homie get his get back for, you know, homie sucker punching him. As would anybody who grew up in the neighborhoods that I have, I get real close to, you know, see what's really popping off. I see the homie Jamal being held back by all of these dudes, right? Yo, like, they're screaming at him, bro, it ain't worth it. It ain't worth it, let it go, calm down. It ain't worth it. The homie's face is literally covered in blood. Think of if someone ran up on you and threw a pail of, it was carried amounts of blood. Like, you remember Carrie, chick that got all the stuff dropped on her at the prom? You know what I mean? Like, but it was just on his face. So I'm like, bro, what the? And then I see the homie's lip is split all the way down the middle. Like, it was bad, man. It was bad. And I'm thinking, like, bro, because he got punched in the face so hard that his teeth went through his lip and it split. I'm like, they don't make no sense based on how the split was clean straight. And then I saw the dude that had did it. The dude was standing there like this. I noticed how tense his forearm was. I was like, bruh, well, either his arm is tense to throw another punch, but the way his hand is, it don't make no sense. Look, I'm gonna be 100% transparent with y'all, all right? I got close to the dude, cause I was thinking about, you know what I mean? Like, giving him one from the side. One of the ones, you know what I mean? Like, from the side, I was gonna hit him with the, and it's at that point that I noticed that he had a knife. And then I immediately started doing calculations in my mind. Cause I was like, okay, what percentage do I have of actually knocking this dude out? You know what I mean? Like, cause if I don't knock him out and he's got a knife, I'm gonna get the same thing Jamal got. You know what I'm saying? So I did what any real one would do in the situation. You know what I mean? Homie just got stabbed. Dude is right in front of me and I'm mad. Like, I ain't just gonna sit here and let that happen. You know what I'm saying? So I did what any real one would do and started snitching immediately. I immediately started telling people that he had a knife on him. Cause look, see what happened was, I didn't want to get what Jamal had gotten. And if he just stabbed the homie in the face, he obviously wouldn't care much about stabbing me in my face. And I was like, I'm not the prettiest dude in the world, but I don't want to be less prettier. You know what I'm saying? So I was, you know what I mean? I backed back and I started telling people, you know what I mean? Like, what had happened and stuff. I started telling people that I saw his knife. He had one of those CSGO, like rainbow colored type of knives that you get off the internet. It was sticking out about this far from his fist. So I'm like, what could have possibly been so bad as to where is you willing to come into a crowded skating rink full of women and kids and stab someone in the face? Why? How, Sway? What, did the DJ not play the song you wanted and then the homie accidentally like stepped on your new skate or something? Everybody was on top of the homie Jamal, you know, pulling him away or whatever. They pull him into a back room and start talking to him. So I find out later, apparently, his girl, you know, like his girlfriend had been arguing with the dude or whatever. And, you know, like the homie Jamal, as any real one would do, came to his chick's defense like, yo, you know what I mean? Like, you ain't gonna be talking to my chick like that. What are you doing? You know, blah, blah, blah. And I guess the dude liked the girl so much, you know, and was so mad that she had a boyfriend. He just stabbed dude. That, what type of, you know what I'm saying? It's crazy too, because I've seen a lot of situations like that happen where a dude get turned down by a female and then just shoot up the whole party. And I was there for like two of those type of situations. So I guess those are some stories I tell y'all as well. One of them was a house party and the other one was a hotel party. We ran on the first one, you know what I mean? We ain't nobody really get hit, but the hotel party, a female got hit in the throat. She survived, but she is different after that. I just don't get it. Now, of course, you know what I mean? There's things I don't know. The worst part is I went and told security what happened, which put him in a real messed up area because it was his job to fix the situation. He just got dude out of there. That's the last time I go skating in California. You know what I'm saying? I'm not gonna be skating in California very many more times after that. Luckily enough, I'm back in Vegas now. You know what I mean? I ain't even gonna keep it real with y'all, bruh. I was scared to walk outside, bruh. I'm like, man, like after something like that, you know, like what's stopping him from just showing up
and shooting people and stuff as they walk out. You know what I mean? And that's why I got myself back in Vegas, where stuff like that don't happen at. You feel me? Hope you guys enjoyed the video. You know, if you did, make sure to comment, like, and or subscribe. You feel me? Link down below. I'm gonna have a link in the description down below to my gaming channel. You know what I mean? I release at least 3 videos a week over there. You feel me? Make sure to go check that out. And there's a link into my reaction channel. Also go check that out, because I'll be doing videos and stuff over there and stuff. And what's messed up is I have crazier stories than that. So stay tuned.